Donald MacLeod on Rory MacLeod's Lament. To get the best interpretation from the ground, as usual, as in all tunes, the little and notes are very important. Remembering the golden rule about the ease of the cadences, that is, although they may vary in length, they are never cut. I often use the cadences as and notes. Apart from the cadences, we have some very short and notes and some quite long. Line one might sound like this. And o hidri, and hidri, hidri, o we la hid hidri, hidri. That really, to me, seems to be one elongated phrase. With a repeat of the line, and o hidri, and hidri, hidri, o we, and hidri, hidri, o he, and hidri, la hi. Line two, and hri chor hri hri oh he and hri and he oh three and oh three hri oh he and hri and he re. With line three, here, three, and o, three, o, three, three, and o, three, and three, three, and o, three, and three, o, e. And on the practice chanter. In variation one, which is perfectly straightforward, we go for balance. We must try to get all our long notes the same length, and in fact our short notes of equal duration. I don't think we should overcut the short notes. Line one might sound like this. And so on. I wonder if variation two might not have been better written in 12/8 time. It's a moot point. If we're going to play it as it is written, then the two tied notes will of course be equal in value to the crotchet, and each of the two tied notes will be of equal duration. That would mean something like this. I think that lacks in character. I think the second of the two tied notes should be that little bit, and only a little bit longer than the first. This sort of thing. Similarly through the variation. Now in both the Turlough and Cronlough singlings, where we come to the end of the phrase and our two tied notes, I notice in the text that both these tied notes are paused. Well, I certainly would not dwell too long on the second of each of the two tied note groups. I would play something like this. Similarly in the Cronlough singling. Of course, each doubling will be that hair's breadth quicker in tempo than the singlings. And I would certainly not play a Cronlough march in this tune.